They scaled the walls, 3 ladders. Ang mga SAF, wearing full battle gear, carrying M16s. I understand there was also a bazooka in Glory Mountain. After that, they were repulsed with the use only of a water cannon and the sheer bravery and force of will of the kingdom citizens. After the peaceful search, we offered them burgers and water and coffee, which they all refused. Where can you see a warrant of arrest being implemented in a very, very rough manner, turning peaceful, and then later on, the persons who were assaulted offering food and drink to those assaulting? Only in the kingdom.
To serve and to protect, ito ang mandato ng ating kapulisan. Pero sa mata ng mahigit na 7 milyong miyembro ng Kingdom of Jesus Christ at milyong-milyong sympathizers at supporters ng mga Pilipino at even those who are not Filipinos who are supporting the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, tila hindi na ito nagampanan ng ating kapulisan. Tanong ng marami sa ating mga kababayan, may violation nga ba na nagawa ang ating mga kapulisan nung iserve nila ang search warrant sa mga kingdom compounds dito sa Davao City? At kasama natin ngayon ating mga legal counsels. Unahin muna natin si Attorney Dina Fuentes Solentino para ibahagi ang kanyang statement.
Thank you. To all those listening, there are 3 levels of truth. Tama, the truth as we see it, wasto, what is right, and tumpak, which is the bigger truth that encompasses both. Hopefully this press conference will reveal not just the truth as we see it, from whichever side you may be, not just what is right, but hopefully the bigger, deeper truth about what happened. Let me tell you a story. At about 3:45 or 3:50, the members of the Kingdom of Jesus started congregating in the Kingdom Plaza. There are a lot of people living inside the compound. It's not like an ordinary church where you go, you celebrate with God, and then you leave. This compound houses thousands of people. And so they stay here, they pray here, they study here, they live here. At 3:45, they started gathering to start their morning devotional at 4 a.m. And bawal malate. So they start gathering and they have to be presentable, at least naka-toothbrush, nakahugas ng muka, nakabihis ng maayos, because when they talk to God, they should be presentable in God's eyes. And later on, you heard what Carlo and Mom Nori said. The police arrived, and even without saying anything, without saying what their purpose was, they started scaling the walls. The security guard said, "I am not authorized. Can you please wait for our lawyer so that the lawyer will be the one to talk to you?" What happened? Instead of listening, they scaled the walls. 3 ladders, ang mga SAF wearing full battle gear, carrying M16s. I understand there was also a bazooka in Glory Mountain. After that, they were repulsed with the use only of a water cannon and the sheer bravery and force of will of the kingdom citizens. After the gate was shut, the lawyers arrived. After Nori talked to them, the lawyers arrived and they were able to negotiate. Attorney Kay Laurente and later Attorney Adam Jambangan were able to talk to them. And because the police were too numerous, do you know how many people there were? How many police? We saw 4 big buses which can house 60 people at least. 1 big truck, open truck. 2 police vehicles, yung open type. Several vans, SUVs, and pickups, all of which were used by the police. So you can imagine there were hundreds of policemen. Now, if the police did not answer the question, how many there were hundreds. All right? And they were wearing, some of them were wearing riot, some of them had riot shields. There were SAF in full battle gear and M16s. So, because of that, the lawyers decided to buy peace. Okay, we will allow you in. And when I arrived at around 5 a.m., because they said, wait for me. And so when I arrived at 5 a.m., I talked to the head who was handling this. And I said, okay, you are allowed to bring 16 people inside per area. 8 uniformed CIDGs and 8 full battle gear SAF to accompany them. 4 areas. The first was JMC, Jose Maria College. And they searched from top to bottom. The second was the Bible school where the pastorals live. It was a dormitory. The third was the kingdom where they went around using vehicles because there's nothing in there. And the fourth, the hangar. So these are 4 groups of 16 policemen accompanied by their lawyer and accompanied also by us. By then, it was already peaceful, thank God. But the damage had been done. Before I allowed them in, I read the warrant of arrest that they were serving from both the Regional Trial Court Branch 12 and the Regional Trial Court Branch 159, if I'm not mistaken, of Pasig City. And then after that, after the peaceful search, we offered them burgers and water and coffee, which they all refused. Where can you see a warrant of arrest being implemented in a very, very rough manner, turning peaceful, and then later on, the persons who were assaulted offering food and drink to those assaulting? Only in the kingdom. And after that, they left. And that is the story here in the central compound of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. There is another story in Glory Mountain. What they said was they were going to do a search warrant. Search warrant, not warrant of arrest. And what happened? Again, the people there said, please wait for our lawyers. They are just in Prayer Mountain, which is near. Please wait for them. Despite that, they brutally tore down the fence, handcuffed young people, traumatized them, threw them like they were dolls, and then searched the place. Now, the police are trying to spin, saying that no, it was peaceful, and it was, they tried to observe due process, but it was the kingdom citizens who broke the law. You will know the truth now. Tama, wasto, and tumpak. Thank you.